Trying to figure out how to install Windows Subsystem for Linux and run Linux GUI apps on Windows 11? In this Windows 11 quick tip, I'll show you how to do that with a minimum of fuss. We start on the Windows 11 desktop. Right-click on Start and choose Terminal Admin. We choose Yes on the UAC prompt. In the Administrative PowerShell prompt, we install Windows Subsystem for Linux by entering the command wsl --install. Running this command triggers the installation of the necessary components and files related to Windows Subsystem for Linux. You'll be prompted to allow this process to make changes, so choose Yes on this dialog. We are doing a default installation process which configures Windows 11 to host Linux distributions and downloads and installs Ubuntu. I'll show you how to install different distributions a little later. To complete the installation, we need to bounce the computer, so I do this with the Restart Computer PowerShell commandlet. Through the magic of television, we're back after a reboot. Once you sign in, the Ubuntu setup process starts. You'll be asked to specify a default username and password. This user will have the ability to perform admin operations using sudo. The first thing to do is to update the distribution. In this case, sudo apt update and sudo apt upgrade. Once the update completes, we close the window. A cool thing about Terminal on Windows 11 is that it will automatically detect new Linux distributions. I restart the Terminal application and Ubuntu is now listed. A cool feature of Windows Subsystem for Linux on Windows 11 is the native support for Linux GUI apps. It's just a matter of installing and running them. Here I install X11 apps, GNOME Text Editor, and Nautilus. Once they are installed, I can run them directly from the Linux shell in Terminal. Here's XSize. Here's the GNOME Text Editor. And here's the Nautilus File Manager running in the WSL environment. Another cool feature of Windows Subsystem for Linux is the ability to run different Linux distributions side by side. To do this, I need to install another distribution and run the command wsl --listo. This lists all the Windows Subsystem for Linux distros I can install directly from the command line. There are more in the Microsoft Store, but there are a bunch you can just install from the PowerShell prompt. Here I choose to install Kali Linux by running the command wsl --install Kali Linux. Kali Linux is downloaded, as the Windows Subsystem for Linux environment is already prepared. No need for a reboot. We are just prompted for a user and password to use with the distribution. Now that Kali Linux is installed, I restart Terminal and can see both Ubuntu and Kali Linux as options. I launch each of these and then use the lsb release command to verify the identity of each distribution. And that's how you install Windows Subsystem for Linux on Windows 11.